Welcome to my channel.
Impressive.
Yeah, this is me. I thought I would just do without the helmet for a change. And the reason is that I looked at my sub count the other day and I noticed I got 400 subs. 400. That's quite a lot. And thanks, guys. I appreciate it. Each and every one of you. Now, if any few of you could just go and do the same on my Instagram, that would be awesome. So, guys, I just wanted to say thank you. This is me. That's about it. Today I thought I'm going to run through the whole dash display, all the settings, and if you guys ever wondered any special features on the MT-07, FZ-07, then keep watching. But yeah, I hope this video can be of help to some guys. Without further doo-doos, let's get going. While we're on the subject of MTFZ, whatever year they are called, the MT from now on, but MT apparently stands for Master of Torque. What does the FZ stand for? Anybody have a clue? Google doesn't know, Yamaha, well, I don't know, but just curious. Let's get on with the video. You know what, I learned a new trick. So if you're standing next to your bike, before you even turn the ignition on, just want to check the time very quickly. You go to the left and you have a right button. Press and hold the left button for a second. Time comes up. That'll show the time for 10 seconds. Display. Quick run through. We've got the time, we've got the fuel gauge. EF, yeah, that's for enough. F is for a hell of a lot of fun, lots to go. You have your, well, they call this the multifunction display. We'll run through that a bit later. Moving over, we have your gear display. Yeah, it actually says their gear. That'll show you what gear you're currently in, and all the way through up until you run out of them at number 6. Moving over, what you can't see but will show up when you guys are cruising along is an ECO, Eco. Now what that means in simple terms, you just going too slowly, okay? It means speed up and ride faster. Seriously, it actually means economical, and you are riding your bike economically according to the little computer box. These numbers, yeah, that's the, oh my god, I'm going too fast. And how fast am I going? Your speedo. Across the bottom here, you have your rev counter, tachometer, whatever you want to call it. It just shows you, gives you enough warning before your engine's about to explode. And yeah, they've built in a lovely feature which will actually stop the engine from exploding. Running through a few of the lights, first of all we have the indicators, flashes, signals, whatever you guys call them, and obviously your hazards. First one, the red one with the oil can on. Yeah, that means you've got low oil pressure. If this comes on while you're riding, stop somewhere and just check your oil. Next to that is engine coolant, and if you run out of your water or engine coolant, that light's going to come on and warn you that your bike's about to catch fire because it's getting too hot. The next one, which I hope we will never ever see, is a little light over here, which is got a little picture of a I don't know why they always put a car's engine on there, because it's a weird little thing with a fan on the front. I don't understand that. I mean, we ride bikes, not cars. But anyway, it's your engine trouble warning light. There's a little orange light as your ABS to show you that, your ABS is functioning. And this light will turn off once you start rolling forward a couple of meters. And the reason is it's actually got to make sure that the wheels are turning and that it can see the brakes. Now, I don't know if you noticed, when the bike was off, there was a little red light flashing here with a little key on it. That is your immobilizer light. That does flash once you've turned the ignition off, removed the key, and walked away from the bike for a while. The immobilizer will kick in. A little red light will start flashing you to say that don't steal me, I belong to somebody else. The next light will be the high beams. Blue, got a little headlight bulb like a car. And yeah, that comes on when you turn your high beam or when you press the push to pass button and you flash the hell out of people with your bright LED bulb. And obviously the big green N is for neutral, no gear, not going anywhere. Let's take a closer look at the multifunction display. We have two buttons, a left and a right button. Cycling through all the features, we obviously have our odometer, which tells you total kilometerage, not mileage, because I ride in kilometers, not miles, so it's my kilometerage. Moving over, we have the first trip meter. I use this one to see how far I go on a tank of fuel. When I fill up, I usually just reset this. Trip number two, I don't do anything with this, so that just keeps rolling over. Another trip meter that will pop up sometime is the trip F. What that means is once you run out of fuel, you get to E for enough and you keep going, the E will start flashing, and if it's really low, the trip F will start counting. And that starts at zero and it starts counting kilometers up, warning you that you actually have around 50 kilometers to go before you have to walk. So yeah, if that trip F comes up, I've pushed it to just over 40, but the bike was still not so empty. But yeah, I would say you limit yourself to around 50, maybe 60 kilometers, which is what, about 30, 35 miles at the most. Don't risk it, otherwise, yeah, you'll end up walking quite far. Now, to reset any of the trip meters, as you select them, you see they flash for a few seconds before they stabilize. So if you want to reset any of those, all you do is you just, while it's flashing, hold down the right button for a second or two and it will reset itself back to zero. Next on the list is the current fuel consumption. And that I learned a small trick with. Now, as you can see, you can have it set to either kilometers per liter or hold down the left button for 2 seconds and it will flick over to liters per 100 kilometers. Now, obviously, if you're in the US or those other places that use miles, this will show up as miles per gallon. Moving along, we have our average liters per 100. So yeah, if you want to reset that, when you select it, just press and hold the right button and it will set it back to zero and start recalculating your average consumption as you get going again. Once again, to change this from liters to kilometers per liter, then you just press and hold the left button and it will show your average kilometers per liter. Next is low. This is your current engine temperature, and this will only start showing a number from about 40 degrees Celsius. When you start your engine, yeah, I would recommend give it a few seconds. It takes a minute or so just before it hits 40 degrees. and you're good to go. Next is the current air temperature. That pretty much sums it up, guys. Let's move on to the clock. How to change the time. Right, in order to set the clock, what you're gonna do is press and hold both buttons for 2 or 3 seconds. You'll see the hour will start flashing. Press the right button to change the hour. Press the left button to select minutes. Pressing the right button to change the number. I know my clock is very fast, so if you press it down, it does seem to go a little bit quicker. And what are we sitting on exactly? 12:30. So let's get it through there. 12:30, once again, left button to select, and your clock starts ticking away. Setting the brightness on your display. You need to start with your ignition off. Press and hold the left button down and turn the key on. Once it's run through its diagnostics, keep holding it and you will get a series of little dots pop up. You can then let go and cycle through the various brightness settings with the right button. 6 brightness settings. Guys, just be aware that of the 6, the very bright one, and if you do a lot of riding at night, it is extremely bright. I usually leave mine on about 4, and that's it. To save, once again, hit the left button, and away you go. Okay, so you want to hear the rev counter? Let me show you the rev counter. Carefully now. That's enough to get the neighbors out, isn't it?